good day. On the 19th of February 2023, the Norwegian newspaper VG published an article titled "The Soldier and the Sunflowers." This article, which is illustrated with several photographs, tells the story of how Ukrainian volunteers rescue the bodies of dead Russian soldiers. To arouse the reader's emotions, the supposed face of a Russian soldier who died in what is portrayed as a senseless Russian war of aggression is described. The article also makes, and this is the ugly part of it, an undocumented claim that the Russians attach explosives to the bodies of dead soldiers in an attempt to kill or injure the Ukrainians. Or, to quote the article, "The Russians attach explosives to the corpses. That way they can injure or kill Ukrainians who try to remove the dead." End of quote. After Russia in February 2022 initiated its military operation to protect Donbas, we have seen a tsunami of anti-Russian lies and hate propaganda. Russia is accused of starting the war. There is no mentioning of the Kyiv regime's terrorist war against Donbas and the killing of thousands of civilians, hundreds of children. There is no mentioning of the Kyiv regime's refusal to fulfill the Minsk agreements by giving self-rule to Donbas. There is no mentioning of the Kyiv regime's attack on Donbas that provoked the Russian military intervention. Western war propaganda claims that Russia is losing the war. Russian losses are grotesquely exaggerated. And of course, Russia is accused of committing war crimes like the Bucha massacre, the bombing of civilian targets, the raping of Ukrainians, the raping even of children. On the other hand, Ukrainian war crimes, like the bombing of civilian targets in Donbas, are never mentioned. By claiming that the Russians place explosives on the bodies of dead soldiers, the mass media, in this case VG, have nevertheless crossed a civilizational border. This is dehumanization. People who act in this way, people who place explosives on the bodies of dead soldiers, they are no longer human beings. And this is actually reminiscent of how the Jews in the Middle Ages were accused of poisoning the wells and thus causing the plague. We are witnessing a dehumanization of Russians as a people that disguises itself as Putin criticism, opposition to the war in Ukraine, etc. Today's dehumanization and demonization of Russia and Russians is far worse than what we experienced during the Cold War. In fact, today's hate propaganda against Russia and Russians is reminiscent of the NS regime's anti-Soviet propaganda during the Second World War. Today, just as during the war, the Russians are portrayed as bloodthirsty, predatory, etc. Russophobia has become the new socially acceptable racism. This demonization of Russia and Russians must be a big mental strain for the 20,000 Russians who live in Norway and their children. The Russian authorities should try to defend them. It would probably be an appropriate measure not to give visas to journalists associated with mass media who engage in the worst hate propaganda. I would strongly urge the Russian embassy not to grant visas to journalists associated with the newspapers VG and Dagbladet, who are the worst peddlers of hatred against Russia and the Russians. The Russian authorities have, of course, a legal right to combat this hate propaganda against the Russians as a people. Hate propaganda aimed at national or ethnic groups is a punishable crime against humanity, as the Nuremberg Tribunal determined after the Second World War. In fact, one of the defendants, Julius Streicher, the publisher of the anti-Semitic weekly Der Stürmer, was sentenced to death and executed solely because he had carried out hate propaganda against an ethnic group. Thank you for your attention.